What is going on, everybody? It is Officer here, and welcome back to another PC modding video. Now, today's video is going to be very interesting and also easy to do, as you only need one thing, and that is OpenIV for this to work. What I'll be showing you on screen is a few instances of what will happen if you do this sort of little method, as I was just dicking about with the files, and it actually turned out really nice. You basically get story mode components on your online character, and again, it's only for PC. Now, before we go through this method, I'd just like to say that if you're interested in humorous things regarding GTA 5 content, I advise checking out a series that I'm starting calling The Weasel Newsroom. It is on my channel. It's the last thing I uploaded. Link could be in the description as well. And I just think that if you have the time on your hands, go check it out. Leave a like. See if you like it. If not, that's okay. But it takes a lot of time to edit stuff like that. I know that now. But anyway, I'll stop wasting your time. So we're going to go right into modding this. Now, if you want to see what exactly this does, I'll show you an example. So here we are in the game files of OpenIV. Since you're modding, you should already have it, but if you don't, it's pretty simple and self-explanatory to set up. Right here, I'm going to some of the online clothing files, and as you can see, this is one of the tops that you wear for your online character as part of the casino DLC, right, the fireman. That's not an EUP top at all. That is a top that you can normally just acquire. All right, and if we click on some of these things, you'll also see, like, there's the duffel bags that you get. These are online components. Excuse me, but with this mod, if I click on this, for instance, you'll see this is Michael's shirt. Now, this red right here indicates that's cloth. That's a completely different beast, and I'll tell you all about how that works later on. Actually, you should probably stay away from stuff like that. But here is Michael's shirt, which you pretty much saw in the thumbnail, and you might have seen in the preview clips, depending on what clips I decide to put in. And this is completely compatible with the online character. So, you're probably asking, well, this is why you're here. How do we do this? Well, there is something else that you need to do, but it's not something you have to download. As you can see right here, I have a merge folder. All you have to do is just right-click, and it doesn't really matter what you name it. You can just call it a new folder, whatever it is. But we're going to go into a merge folder, and we're going to create two subfolders in between. Again, it does not matter what the merge folder is called, what these folders are. This is just for your convenience. What I have right here are backups that I will drag from the MP ped as a backup to make sure that it works. And here are peds that I will be tops I will be converting. Now, last night I was thinking about what tops I don't already have, and this is actually Michael's polo shirt. So if we were to go to the GTA 5 directory, and we were to go to, let's go to X64V, and all the clothing is going to be in X64V.rpf. You're going to want to click on edit mode, and you're going to want to click on show mods folder. Now, because I already have something in that spot, just click on show in mods folder and it should just go away. But I already have something in that spot because this is actually a different type of Michael I have just for my computer, but it should be no different. Just click on show in mods folder. You're going to want to go to the streamed ped players.rpf, double click on that. Player 1 is Franklin, player 2 is Trevor, and player 0 is Michael. We're going to double click on that. All right. And you can click through all of these. Now, the thing about this is JBIB is not the same thing as upper. Online components are different. Online components have JBIB as their top, whereas upper is the top for Michael. If we go to here, the upper 17, it should be right there. This should be the polo shirt, which we want to get. And here it is right here. So we're going to exit out of that. That is what we're going to convert to the online character. So we're just going to drag that into there. I already have it in there. And you're going to want to scroll down to, that was called upper 17. So you're going to want to scroll down, or you can type up here and filter 017. And it's even more convenient. So now these files are texture files, and basically that goes on top of that model to give you the skin looking effect. So we have all these in there, and you just drag them all. Here's a tan version of the polo shirt. Don't worry about the textures here. You're going to want to select all these textures and drag them into a folder, that merge folder. All right, I already have them here. These are the exact same things. Excuse me. So we're going to go back into the mods folder. Now, here, make sure that you exit out of here. I almost forgot that, otherwise you will not see anything. So here we're going to go into the mods, go into update, X64, DLC packs. And this is where you can choose what tops you want to replace. Now, if you want to make this very convenient for yourself and replace the latest things of the casino heist, it is MP heist tree, but also you can replace it in anything else here. So we're going to go to MP heist tree, DLC.rpf, and we're going to go to common, data, I'm sorry, we're going to go to X64 models, I do apologize there, CD images, and you're just going to want to go click on one of these here. So if I go to MP High Stream Mail, it should take a little bit to load, go here, And basically, here are the things that you can replace. Now, JBIB is, like I said earlier, what the tops are. So since this is a top right here, trousers work a little bit differently. You can only wear components for story mode trousers if you have a story mode top. Otherwise, it will completely glitch out. So we're typing JBIB up in the top right-hand corner, and that makes filtering a lot easier. Now, if we click on all these, you'll see I've already replaced many of these models. Like right here, for instance, this is Michael's tennis top. And JBIB 16 is a sweater vest from Devin Weston, excuse me. So you just want to find a slot. If you already have some things replaced, like there's Trevor's jacket right there. For me, it may be different, but if you want to replace something like this, you simply will rename this file to a file that you want to replace in here. Now, I advise strongly that that other folder that you made in the MP backup, if you, for instance, if you want to replace JBIB 15, you drag JBIB 15 into that folder, and then you'd scroll down to where it says JBIB different 15, DIFF, and that would only be this right here, and you would drag that into the folder as well. So basically the numbers and JBIB and the numbers are what you want to drag into the folder. Now I already have tops occupying all of these positions, so in my predicaments, it may be requiring me to replace this in another one. But we will do that just in case you want to do something different here. So we're going to exit out of this, and we're going to find a different slot that we can put our top in. So as for me, I'm trying to recall what I don't have many components in, as well as EUP. Be careful, because this can overwrite your EUP. So it's the same process if you went into a different folder as well. You want to go to lowrider male or female, even though they're all really male components, and just click on something that you know you don't have something to replace. Now, for instance, this right here, this top I've never seen before, I do not have that replaced by anything. Same thing here. So what we're going to do is, in my case, and again, you could stay in that other folder, this is just for me showing you, for the sake of the video, how easy this is to do. So let's say I want to replace this big t-shirt, right? What I would do is I would drag jbib000.u into my backup folder. And I would locate that jbib, and you're going to find the 000 right here. And these difference means there's different types of textures that go for it. And if you have a clothing, for instance, like jbib different 2 actually is probably better, because look at how many more letters it has. That means it has more texture slots. That means you can get more of your textures in. JBIB 2 would be this polo shirt right here, which I don't know if EUP takes that. So actually, we'll replace JBIB 2. In my case, again, you could stay in the MP history folder. And we're going to go to JBIB 2 different, and we're going to hold down the control button, select all the files as a means of backing up, even though we won't need all these files, because Michael's shirt doesn't even take up this many files. But we're going to drag them into here. Now we have backups of those files in case something goes wrong. We're going to go back to our convert folder, and you're supposed to drag in the uppers that you wanted by looking through all the models, or the lowers. It's the same thing, and you just want to rename the JBIB file that we replaced right here, 02. We're going to rename this upper 17 RYDD. We're going to backspace, and we're going to name it exactly what this name is. So it's going to be JBIB _002_U. And there, ooh, I spelled that incorrectly. JBob, right? No, JBIB. All right, and what we're going to do is we're going to drag that into there. You can see the file size went up. If we double click on it, you will see Michael's polo is white, but do not worry, because that is what we're going to fix in just a second. Now, since that was JBIB 2, we're going to go right here, and you're going to see this is what we're replacing next. As you can see, these are the original textures from the shirt that we were replacing. So we're going to take that name, and we're going to rename it to exactly what the first one says. JBIB_different_002_A_U_I. Now, to make this easy on yourself, I would rename the file, Control-C, click off, and then if we drag it in there, and we double-click, now you can see Michael's texture has been replaced. All you have to do is just rinse and repeat this for the rest of the files, except you just have to change the letter, and if you keep going down, then it's completely fine. Now, do keep in mind that if you do this with trousers or accessories, this WHI may be a UNI, may be a YARD or something like that. Just make sure that you're very persistent in the naming. as to what the files are, because if you name it something different from what the game has it as, then it will not load into your game. You'll have invisible components. So we're just going to keep renaming this, and we'll click through them in just a second here. Okay, so we are back, and we just renamed all these things, so that way, and we dragged them in, so we named them here, and we dragged them in here, and as you can see, as we click through, we've got different variations of the Michael Top already on our modeling character. There's a red version of the ship. Now, keep in mind, I do not advise doing this with Michael's suit, as there are cloth directories, and that will make the suit look completely broken, or anything with cloth. For instance, if you ragdoll in story mode, and let's say, like, the shirt goes up, like, for instance, Michael's open shirt, or the suit, most suits that story mode characters have broken textures, so you can't really use them in online, but you could if you wanted to, you just won't have half of the thing. But there you go, we have the polo shirt replaced. So what we're going to do is we can take these out of the convert, we can just delete them right now, we don't need them anymore. And if you want, and if your game does not load up well, you can delete all these files, but you should replace these files by dragging them right back into the respective directory. But since I know this, I've been doing this for a long time, I'm just going to delete them because I know it will work. Now, I will see you in the game when we get there.
Only days after the trial, you could feel the tension rise, here in the street and in the rhythm of despair. Of despair, it was war after a while. In each neighbor's tired eyes.
Alright, so now that we're in the game, I'm going to teleport somewhere so that way you can see what we're doing, because the police station is a tad bit dark, especially with these graphics mods I have in. Alright, so before I show you what we just got, for what I replaced, at least where I was, I'll just showcase to you that if we change to the online character, which we'll just find a, we'll just go into a generic online character, for instance, so we'll just go to model change and menu, and you will need any mod menu for this. I just like using menu because it is rather user friendly, and we'll just go to the free mode male, which is the pad that we will be replacing. We'll make sure he has default components, so I'll show you exactly what we just got. So, as you can see, my earlier conversions worked just fine. Here are some of the clothing from story mode. As you can see, there's Michael's sweater, suit and whatnot. And that's exactly why suits are not very good, because of the cloth that works with them. So we're going to go and try to find that lowrider clothing that we just replaced with Michael, which will be a bit into the actual game. So we'll find that here in just a second. Oh, there it was. Alright, and as you can see, this is the lowrider clothing. Now, you may need to change the torso accordingly to compensate for any sort of clipping issues, for instance, something like that. Whichever works for you. I will tell you one thing, the skinning of things that have sleeves is not the easiest to manage, I will say that. As you can see, the arms are a little bit glitchy. We can actually change the top, since we replaced the colors, of course, right there. And there are other versions of the polo shirt that are overwritten by the online textures, so you can get some funny effects. But the main shirts are basically these right here, as you can see. I guess we forgot to rename this texture, which is completely fine. So there you guys have it. That is basically how to get any models. And before I do leave you guys today, I would like to show you what happens if you replace some of the trousers. Now, I do replace, these are Michael's jeans, but we'll go with Michael's shorts just to make the Michael uniform. Now, if you look at something, these shorts, the entire trousers model, come with the flip-flops. And if you look at the bottom there, my shoes are completely glitched out, as you can see. The only way to fix this problem is to make sure that you also convert some shoes, which do take extra work, though it is just renaming files. So as you can see right there, if I turn off the shoes, for instance, then we have no issues. If we converted Michael's suit pants right here, these trousers, we have to make sure that we convert his actual trousers shoes, and they will look normal once we find them in just a second here. They should be here somewhere. And you'll know that they're correctly converted there, as you can see that there's no weird clipping going on. And basically right now what we're wearing is Michael's complete uniform, well, one of them. And the last thing I need to showcase to you is if you do decide to wear the trousers without an online top, you'll get some weird glitching effects like this. The only way to counteract this is to make sure that you have a story mode top like this itself. Now, this also works with any other story mode top, just so long as you have one. However, that means that any accessories that you have, such as police belts or whatnot, cannot be on the character model. So, for instance, if I decide to put on some police armor or police belts, it will glitch out like that. Accessories, however, are completely fine. You can have these accessories on if you want, blah, blah, blah. Whatever you want to have on your character in this regard, you can have without them glitching. But there you guys have it. That is the tutorial. And that being said, guys, I will see you all in the next video. Have a good one.